top of the middle of the day to you boys and girls. We're at the Big Kid Woodlot for a little saw off. We're going to be running a completely bone stock down to the stops in the carburetor. MS461, sporting a 32-inch still lightweight bar, Oregon full skip, full chisel chain. We're going to run that against the 038 from the carburation adjustment video. I never ran the 038s because the timber was always too big out on the coast to run those little saws, so I don't have much experience with them, truth be told. We'll take a look at it a little bit here for a second. One thing I forgot to mention in that video is we rhino liner to technically the handlebars. It's textured, which is pretty sweet. You can tell looking at inside the clutch cover, this saw hasn't even thrown the chain yet, all original. Pretty sweet little operation, really. I guess they're around 5 horsepower or so, maybe a little bit less factory rating. The 461s come in around 6, so just out of the box, it's way down on power. We did Psycho-ized this particular version, though. I wanted to run it to get some 044s I have later. But anyway, I guess we're going to make a test cut with the 461. We're going to check the upper RPM limit. I think it's going to come in around 13.5 or so, 13.6. I'll try to get the 038 adjusted to the same for run number one. Then we're going to tighten down the high speed a little bit. A lot of the saws from the 80s, like even the 288, for example, if you had them cracking pretty good at high idle, they were kind of bulletproof. I thought initially this saw would be one of those 15,000 RPM range saws, 15 to 16 based on the size. 72.5 cc's for the 038, 76.45 I believe it is for the 461. So we're giving up a lot of displacement as well. But anyway, back on track, it might be one of those that needs a lot of blubbering. Especially if you think about the airflow characteristics. This is a, you know, saw that came out in 1980, I think it was. So the flow design was, they're working on it, let's just say that. Kind of a heck of an upgrade when they came out with the 64, conceptually how they pull air through the filter and in through the cylinder, through the carburetor into the cylinder, technically. That would be the third or fourth generation of refining the process, so a lot of years in difference in design, giving up a lot of displacement. I think that the 038 is going to take the stock 461, so we'll have a bar change in the middle. Let's check that out. Mm-hmm. Now you can hear the 461's bumping up against the limiter and the coil, so we came in around 13.56 for this run. Let's see how she does in the wood. So we managed 10.92 in the wood, a little bit of a wardrobe malfunction with the bark, and I'm trying to take little thin slices because you can see we're running out of log. Well, I will mention the 038 is going to be cutting really close to a big old knot. We'll take a look at that here in a minute. The other thing I forgot to mention, the 038 has a Bing version carburetor. They seem to be a little sensitive to tuning, I've noticed on this particular saw.
Mm-hmm.
above it just before this last time. Not running too bad in a cut. Let's take a look at what we were sawing in and also kind of bogged down the first little go round. Here's the knot. You can see pretty good size, 3 inches at least. Last cut right through the side of it. The previous cut, these are both 038 runs right here. Getting pretty close. You can see the 461 elevation wise. This is the cut it made. So if the 038's running anywhere close to about the same, that says a lot for the tune on the saw. We kind of did it more of a torque tune concept with this saw. Wanted it to, like I said, I think already run with some 044s. But anyway, I'm actually really well pleased at how that saw runs, considering the airflow characteristics of this saw are really not too great compared to like the 044 concept. Really restricted. Got a little bit of air coming in through the back, a little bit coming in through the top, and that's about it. So, like I said, well pleased at how this saw runs. Kind of gets with it. Super awesome shape. Lucky to have it at this point. But anyway, thanks for watching this session. Have a great weekend and a blessed day wherever you might be on God's green earth.